Okay, in this video, I'll show you guys the best way to integrate these two really common integrals. And you see, the answers that we get right here, they will actually be really good formulas that we can use for other questions. All right, enough talking. This is how we are going to do it. We notice that we have cosine of bx, and here we have I of bx. What we are going to do is, let me invite the complex number to help us out. And this is what I'm going to consider first. I'm actually going to multiply the second integral by the imaginary unit I, and then we can use the Euler's formula to help us out. So let me write this down for you guys. First of all, we have the integral of e to the x, and then this right here is cosine of bx. And then, of course, we have the dx here. And as I said, I'm going to add and multiply this by I, and then the integral e to the ax, and then we have sine of bx, like this. And now check this out. If you look at the red part, and let me recall the Euler's formula for you guys. When we have e to the I theta, this right here, thanks to Euler, we know this is cosine of theta plus I times sine theta. Well, if you just look at the red part, take theta as bx. This, and that together, we can go back to e to the I, and we just put on bx for the theta. So now, we will put these two integrals together. We have the integral, and we'll factor out the e to the ax. And when you combine this and that, we get e. And let me just put on the I first, and then the input here, the theta, is our bx. So this right here is pretty much it, right? And this is really, really nice because both of them have e for the base. Of course, now we can just add the powers. So this is the integral e to the a plus ib times x dx, right? We factor out the x and put it right here. So this is it. And to integrate this, it's so nice because this is like saying e to a constant multiple times x. To integrate that, well, this part stays. So I will just write down e to the a plus ib times x. However, don't forget to check the derivative of this. The derivative of a plus ib times x is just a plus ib. When you do the antiderivative, you have to divide. So I feel like, you know, dancing. Divided by that, a plus ib, right? So it's 1 over that. All right, so we integrate it. Now, what is this, though? Now, check this out. If you look at the original two integrals, they are so real. Well, if you look at this part, this is real plus I times real. So we can say that this right here is the real part, and this right here is the imaginary part. And then we integrate it. This is our answer at the moment. I just had to do some more work so that I can figure out the real part and then the imaginary part. And then I'll just, you know, mix and match. And that would be pretty much, that's the strategy. That's so nice, right? And to do so, well, I don't like to be on the bottom. I like to be on the top. You should be on the top as well. So let me just do that. And to do this, I will multiply the top and bottom by a minus ib, the conjugate of that, right? So let's multiply top and bottom by a minus ib. And for this right here, I will also kind of split out the real part and also the imaginary part. To do that here, you see here is just ax plus ibx. This is e to this power, right? And now we are going to do this carefully. First of all, let's just put on the real part first, right? So we'll see what we can do. If you multiply this out, well, it just get a square. Let me just write this down right here, a square. And usually it's minus this thing square. But when you have I square, you get negative 1. Therefore, it becomes a plus. And then you just have b square for the denominator, right? So this is nice for the bottom now because we have a square plus b square. On the top, though, we have this, which is just a minus ib, and you can split the fraction now, right? So what I want to do is, I will just, actually, I will have to keep that. Let me just write down the 1 over right here, all the way in the front, 1 over a squared plus b squared, right? I'm not going to split fraction yet because I have to actually multiply. Because if you look at this part, e to the ax plus ibx is like saying like that, e to the ax times e to the ibx. E to the ax, it's real for sure. So I will also put that down right here, and perhaps I'll put it right here, e to the ax, okay? So this is the real thing that we can do at the moment. This is actually just a coefficient, right? We still have to figure out more things. Now, what I haven't done is the following. I will have to multiply this guy, which is a minus ib, and I also have to work out the e to the ibx right here, right? You have the e to the ibx. And what's e to the ibx? Look back here again. E to the ibx is just cosine of bx plus I times sine of bx. So I will actually have to multiply this by cosine of bx plus I times sine of bx. Like that. So that's what we have to do at the moment, right? We have all the real numbers in the front, and then this right here, we still have to figure out the real part and also the imaginary part. To do so, just do the usual foiling. And perhaps I'll write this down all the way in the front. First, we have e to the ax over a squared plus b squared. That's nice. And now let's do this. First of all, let's figure out the real part when you multiply this out. Well, a times this, that's real, so I'll just write that down first. I will write this down in red, like in black, why not? So we have a times cosine of bx, right? Well, if you do this times that, that's going to be having the I, so that will be imaginary. Likewise, if you do this times that, you have the I. Another real part is when you do this times that. I times I is negative 1, it's real now. And then negative 1 times the negative, you get plus. So you have plus, and then you have the b times sine of bx. This right here, it's the real part. And then I'm going to work out this right here. Let's do the imaginary part. When you do a times this, you know what? I want to just make the arrow in black, like much better. So you have the answer right here, and you have the answer right here. Okay, anyway, this times that, you have the I, so I will first write down plus I, let me just factor out the I first, and then a times this, which is a sine of bx. Then you are going to have this times that. That has the I, that's factored in the front, and this is going to be a minus, and then we have b times cosine of bx, like that. Very nice, very nice. Right? And all that is in that big parentheses. Right? So, in fact, we are done already. Now, let's just pick out the answer. First of all, this right here, it's the real part of our answer here. Why? Because this was the real part, right? So this right here has to be this times that, the real part. Don't forget the coefficient all the way in the front. So let me just write this down right here for you guys. We have e to the ax, and we have that over a squared plus b squared, and then we multiply this by a times cosine of bx, and then we add b times sine of bx. Very nice, very nice. And then in the end, if you would like, just put down plus c. For the second one, well, it's the imaginary part right here, and we have to pick up this right here. Don't forget to multiply this though, right? So I'll just write this down all in blue for you guys. We have e to the ax over a squared plus b squared, and then we multiply by this. Don't put on the I, right? We just want to use that to figure out what the imaginary part, like this right here, is. So you just write down a times sine of bx, and then minus b times cosine of bx, like that. Done. So put plus c right here as well. And let me just put on that box for you guys right here. Okay?